Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe and share.
Alright, so in our previous class, you have learned about concept monohybrid. Okay, so monohybrid, my Mendel said this is referred to one gene. Kita tengok satu jin sahaja. And then this one gene is referred to one characteristic. Okay, for example, color. Okay, and then this one gene is controlled by pair of allele. Controlled by pair of allele. For example, color. Color we have P besar for purple. And then P kecil for white. So this is mean by pair of allele. And then the allele will have two, which is dominant allele and recessive allele. So in this case, P besar, which the phenotype is purple, the trait is purple. This is referred to dominant allele. And then P kecil, D for carry white, white trait. This is recessive allele. So ini apa Mendel cakap. And then from this, monohybrid can be divided into three important cross. First is pure breeding atau also known as true breeding. Okay, and then we have test cross and also monohybrid self cross. Okay. So, daripada tiga-tiga cross tu sebenarnya sangat simple pemahamannya. Pemahaman dia sangat simple. Ya Allah, cantiknya. Okay, apa yang kamu kena faham? Okay, this one is type of cross. Okay, katakanlah first is pure breeding. So, pure breeding, parentnya adalah homozygote dominant cross with homozygote recessive. So dia punya parent genotype is P besar cross with P kecil. Okay, so apa dia punya gamet di sini? This one is P besar, this one is P kecil. Okay, so this is called F1 genotype. Okay, apa yang dia dapat? P besar, P kecil. What is the F1 phenotype? Apa phenotype dia? Purple. Nampak tak?
Nampak.
Okay, so means that in pure breed, all of the progeny, which is F1 generation, with purple color. So the purple color is referred to dominant trait, ciri dominant. Nampak tak? Sebab adanya dominant allele. So dia hanya tonjolkan ciri dominant sahaja. Okay. So ini kita panggil sebagai F1. So lepas tu kita buat pula test cross. Okay. Bila kata test cross, parentnya adalah dominant phenotype. Cross dengan siapa? Homozygote recessive. So dominant phenotype ni boleh jadi P besar dan boleh jadi P besar, P kecil. Tapi bila kata P besar itu dah namanya pure breeding. So dominant phenotype sekarang ni kamu buat saja dalam keadaan heterozygous, iaitu P besar, P kecil. Kahwin dengan siapa? Cross dengan homozygote recessive. So P kecil, P kecil. And then what is the gamete? Gametnya adalah P besar, P kecil. Then this one is P kecil. Okay. And then when the fertilization occur, it will give F2 generation. Sebabnya apa? Ini is consider as F1. The first parent, okay, is consider as F1. Jadi kita boleh katakan kat sini sebagai F2 genotype. So F2 genotype is P besar, P kecil. And then another one is P kecil, P kecil. So nampak dekat situ? P besar, P kecil. The F2 phenotype is purple. P kecil, P kecil is white. So what is the phenotypic ratio? Phenotypic ratio adalah 1 purple, 1 white. Maksudnya 50-50. Kalau dia dapat 100 anak tu, 50 white, 50 lagi purple. Atau dia takkan exactly macam tu lah. 47 purple, lagi 53 adalah white. Ha, so dia akan dapat ratio 1-1. So bila kamu nampak ratio 1-1, contohnya nilainya adalah 53-56. So kamu dah tahu dah parentnya apa. Mestilah heterozygote kahwin dengan homozygote recessive. Kalau dapat anak semuanya dengan ciri dominan, langsung tak ada anak ciri resesif. Kita dah tahu dah. Mesti dia punya parent adalah homozygote dominant cross with homozygote recessive. Okay. But for self-cross, okay, for self-cross is F1 cross F1. So F1 is come from pure breeding. So now F1, the parent is P besar, P kecil cross with P besar, P kecil. So what is the gamete? Both we have P besar, P kecil. P besar, P kecil. Okay, so this is the gamete. And then when fertilized, still kita tulis sebagai F2 genotype eh. Kenapa? Sebab ni F1 cross F1. So, apa kita dapat? P besar, P besar. P besar, P kecil. P besar, P kecil. P kecil, P kecil. How about F2 phenotype? This one will give purple. This one also purple. This one also purple. And how about this? White. So, how about phenotypic ratio? Apa kita dapat? 3 purple and then 1 white. So the ratio is 3-1. 3 with dominant trait, ciri dominant. 1 ni adalah ciri recessive. So let's say kalau soalan tu bagi, dia kata 75 adalah purple, 25 adalah white. So terus otak kamu cerah, oh nombor satu tu sangat besar, lagi satu tu kecil. So sah, ini rasionya adalah 3:1. Bila 3:1, itu maksudnya adalah mono hybrid self cross. Jadi parent dia mestilah heterozygote kahwin dengan heterozygote. Okay, kita memang boleh terus cerah sebenarnya. Apa-apa pun mesti tengok kepada ratio. Boleh faham?
Boleh.
Okay. Boleh. Alright, now itu apa yang Mendel kata tentang monohybrid. Okay. Tapi tak semua ikut apa Mendel kata. Mendel kata macam ni. Mendel dah kata dah. Mendel cakap apa ni, satu gen bawa satu karakteristik sahaja. Lepas tu gen ini hanya melibatkan sepasang allele. Dan sebenarnya Mendel kata satu gen pada satu kromosom. Mendel kata satu gen pada satu kromosom. Dan sepatutnya ini ratio yang kita dapat. Bila buat pure breed, memang akan dapat semua dengan dominant trait. Bila buat test cross, akan dapat 1:1. 50 ciri dominant, 50% lagi ciri recessive. Bila buat self cross, akan dapat 3:1. 3 ni dengan ciri dominant dan 1 ni dengan ciri recessive. Tapi hari ni apa yang kita nak tengok adalah deviation from Mendel's law. Apa yang Mendel cakap tu sebenarnya tak boleh di-apply untuk semua keadaan. Deviation from Mendelian's law ni menunjukkan adalah kes-kes yang tak ikut apa Mendel cakap. Kes-kes yang takkan dapat ratio seperti mana tadi. Bila buat test cross dapat 1:1. Bila buat self cross akan dapat 3:1. Tidak. Okey. Jadi untuk kamu punya syllabus ada 6 case that deviate from Mendelian's law. Ada 6 case yang sebenarnya tak ikut apa Mendel cakap. So kita mulakan dengan yang menunjukkan kepada monohybrid dulu, okey? Okey, pertama kita ambil sebagai codominance allele. Codominance allele. Co. What is mean by co? Codominant allele means both allele of a pair are fully expressed in heterozygous condition. Sama-sama dominant. Allele tu sama-sama dominant. Mendel kata tadi akan ada satu allele dominant, satu allele recessive. Tapi apa yang tapi dalam kes ini ada allele yang sama-sama dominant. Okey, ada allele yang sama-sama dominant. Okey, contoh codominant allele example adalah LM LN blood group. Actually dia refer kepada one gene. Apa dia? Blood group. Bila kata one gene, apa yang jadi dekat dia? Dia akan melibatkan berapa allele? Bila kata one gene ada berapa allele?
Dua
allele. What is the allele? The allele is allele LM. This is for M blood. And another allele is LN. This is for N blood. Okay. But according to Mendel, one allele must be dominant allele. And the another allele must be recessive allele. Betul?
Betul.
Okay. Tengok ni apa dia kata ni? Saya kata apa tadi? Codominant allele, allele ini adalah sama-sama dominant. So MLM is dominant allele. LN also dominant allele. So when the genotype is LM, LM, what type of blood ni akan dapat? What group of blood?
M.
M. Okay. Okay, but then if the genotype is LN, what is the blood group?
N.
Okay, good. But then how about the genotype of heterozygote? LM, LN.
MN blood group.
Kita tak boleh sebut M. Tak boleh. Sebab N pun dominan. Jadi dua-dua tonjolkan ciri dia. So dua-dua tak nak mengalah. So bila dua-dua tak nak mengalah, so this is called as MN blood group. Why? Because both dominant. Dua-dua tak nak mengalah. Dua-dua kena sebut. Faham? LM, LN blood. Dapat?
Dapat.
Okay, good. Now, okay. According to this, try to construct self-cross. Self-cross. Bila kata self-cross, kita dah tahu tadi kan, parentnya adalah heterozygote cross dengan heterozygote. Cuba kamu buat. Ni buat self-cross. Okay, buat sekarang. Nanti saya panggil. Parental genotype. Is LM, LN cross with LM, LN. Okay, The parental genotype is LMLN crossed with LN, LMLN. And then the gamete, okay, for this parent has two gamete, which is LM, LN. Okay, and then this parent also has LM, LN gamete. And then the gamete fertilized to produce F2 genotype. The gamete is when the fertilized first producing LM, LM. And then the second is LM, LN. Then the third one, LM, LN. And the final one is LN, LN. Okay, so as usual, after F2 genotype, you have to write F2 phenotype. LM, LM. What is the blood type, blood group?
M.
M. Then this one? LM, LN. M and blood. This one?
M.
Pandai. Last one? M. Okay. Now, after F2 phenotype, apa yang kita akan buat? Kita akan buat genotypic ratio. Kalau kata kat bawah ni kamu nak buat genotypic ratio, tak ada masalah. Kamu boleh tulis genotypic ratio. Apa kita dapat? 1, 2, 1. Betul? And then, apa dia punya phenotypic ratio? One M blood, betul tak?
Betul.
Jadi?
2 mm blood.
Then? 1 mm blood. So, what is the phenotypic ratio? 1, 2, 1. Sama tak macam Mendel? Mendel kata tadi, kalaulah monohybrid, monohybrid case, which is refer to one gene, when we do the test, the self-cross, we should have 3 dominant, 1 recessive. Means the phenotypic ratio is 3:1. But now, in this co-dominant allele case, ada tak kita dapat 3 nisbah 1? Dapat. Kalau nak ikut, betul lah. Dia pun melibatkan satu gen, betul tak? So, maksudnya ini adalah mono hybrid. Tapi at the end, kita tak dapat pun 3 nisbah 1. So, that's why lah kita kata dia deviate from Mendelian's law. Not obey Mendel's law. So kalau kata soalan tanya kamu, do this LMLN blood group obey ataupun follow Mendelian's law? What is your answer?
Disobey.
Not ataupun disobey. What is the reason? Kalau dia minta markah 3. Tadi tu kamu kata not ataupun disobey. Satu markah. Lagi markah kedua dan ketiga sebab apa? Sebab apa? Kenapa? This is not follow Mendelian's law.
It has 2 alleles that dominate?
Yes, good. Because both alleles are dominant. Lagi? Another one reason. Another one reason.
Both show their characteristics.
No. Lebih besar daripada itu. Lebih besar daripada itu.
The phenotypic ratio is not 3:1.
Yes, good. The phenotypic ratio for self cross is not 3:1. Boleh dapat? Phenotypic ratio for self cross is not 3:1. Jadi disebabkan dua perkara ini, dia deviate from Mendelian's law, not follow Mendelian's law. Boleh faham? So, multiple allele mean more than 2 allele control for the same gene. More than, kamu boleh tengok exactly definition dekat dalam buku kamu lah, dekat dalam bullet tu. Okay, so kefahamannya multiple allele mean more than two allele control for the same gene. Example, ABO blood group. Okay, ABO blood group. So the gene is one gene. Apa one gene yang kita nak tengok tu? Iaitu blood group. So sepatutnya one gene controlled by how many allele? One gene kalau Mendel kata sepatutnya controlled by two allele. But in this case, this blood group controlled by three allele. Ada tiga allele. Apa allele tu? Kita ada allele IA. IA is dominant allele. And it will give A blood. Second, we have allele IB. This is also dominant allele actually and will give blood group B. And the third one is IO. Also can be wrote like this, I. And this is actually recessive allele and will give O blood. So nampak kat situ? Ada tiga allele. Okay. So apa yang jadi? Bila ada tiga allele di sini, dia boleh menjadi combination yang macam-macam combination. Okay, IA boleh jadi dengan IB. IB boleh juga dengan IO. So terjadilah macam-macam. Contoh, okay. So kita di sini yang kamu kena ingat adalah, that's why kalau ada blood type, kita ada berapa jenis blood group? Kita ada A blood. Lagi kita ada apa?
B.
Blood group. Lagi? A, B blood group dan O blood. Ha. So here is the genotype. Kalau blood group A, kamu rasa what is the genotype?
IA, IO.
Pandai. We have two possible genotype. IA, IA, obviously it will give A blood lah. IA, IO, why also have A blood? Because IO is recessive. So A yang menonjol. So kita, that's why lah dapat darah A. And then B. How about B? Darah B. Apa genotype?
IB, 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 IO.
Pandai. Dan IB, IO. Same reason. Okay, because IB is dominant allele. So when it together with recessive allele, so B menonjol, that's why lah IB, IO akan dapat darah B. How about AB blood? Apa genotype dia?
IB. IB.
Okey, kenapa jadi macam ni? Kenapa?
Sebab dua-dua dominant.
Pandai. Because both dominant allele. So, the relationship between IA, IB, it show co-dominant case juga. Betul tak? Dua-dua nak menonjol. Dua-dua tak mau ngalah.
Yes, ma'am.
Pandai. And then how about O blood?
IO, IO.
IO, IO. Atau kita boleh tulis I kecil. Okay. So ini memang kita tahulah hanya ini sahaja genotipnya. Sebab IO is recessive. So to express the recessive trait, it must be in homozygous recessive. The genotype mestilah dalam keadaan homozygous recessive. Okay. Now, if the question asks you, okay, construct the self cross between IA, IO with IA, I O. Buat sekarang. Buat sekarang. The safe cross between I A I O, I A I O. What? Okay. Dah, siap dah. Dah siap belum?
Belum.
Laju sangat kan kalau buat tu. Okay. Saya buat sama-sama dengan kamu. Ingat tepi tu tulis penuh ha. Lepas tu F1, F2 tu, tu ni dalam bentuk sub tau. Subscript. Kalau kamu buat F2 tu F dengan 2 tu sama besar, jawapan kamu salah. Over kadang-kadang diorang ni. Saya pun tak tahu kenapa over and sampai macam tu. Okay. Tak smooth lah. Tak pelan eh. Okay, I'm done. How about you? Hello?
Done.
Okay. My question is, tengok sekarang ni your genetic diagram. What is the phenotypic ratio? What is the phenotypic ratio?
3A blood.
3-1.
Okay, 3 with A blood, which is dominant. Betul tak? 1 is O blood, which is recessive. Okay, let's see. Dia dah suruh kamu construct bagai-bagai macam ni. Siap, siap. And then, bawah soalan genetic diagram ni dia tanya, do this case obey or follow Mendelian's law? Apa kamu nak jawab? Obey ke tak obey?
Obey.
Pasti obey.
Yes.
Confident.
Yes.
Confident. Ada tak yang kata no? Cepikir sikit. Obey ke tak obey ni?
Tak obey.
Nah, tak obey pula dah.
I think obey.
Ada yang obey, ada yang tak obey. Okay, the answer is not obey. Why not obey? Because here, nampak tak di sini? Awal-awal lagi, dia tak mengikut Mendel. Kalau Mendel kata, one gene control by two allele. Jadi, this case is not obey Mendelian's law because one gene is controlled by more than two allele, which is three. Jadi, awal-awal pun memang dah salah. Even dia suruh kamu buat ni, kamu nampak tiga ni sebelah satu. Ah, betul lah. Cuba pula kamu buat IA, IB cross dengan IA, IB. Ada kamu dapat tiga ni sebelah satu? Tak ada maknanya. Faham?
Yes, Madam. Faham.
So, this reason, tentunya dia akan dalam dua markah je. Not obey. Because of what? Because Wan Jin has multiple allele. Ataupun boleh kata Wan Jin controlled by more than two allele. Memang betul lah jawapan kamu. Because Wan Jin is controlled by more than two allele. Kita tak cerita dah bab ratio di sini. Faham? Faham tak? So soalan kena, kamu kena kritikal. Kamu kena kritikal. Okay. Ready untuk yang seterusnya? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Third case. Is in complete dominant allele. Incomplete. Apa yang saya je ni? Incomplete dominant allele. Incomplete. Apa maksud incomplete?
Tak lengkap.
Tak lengkap. Tak lengkap. So dia punya dominansi tu tak lengkap. So contohnya, example is snapdragon color. Snapdragon flower color. Okay. Snapdragon flower color. Flower color. So this is refer to one gene. Apa gene dia? Adalah color. Bila kata one gene, ada berapa allele yang terlibat kalau ikut Mendel?
Wow.
Yes, kali ni cun dua allele sahaja. What is the allele? Allele is CR. This one is for red. And then another one is CW. This is bring white. What happened here? The CR and CW both are incomplete dominants. Kedua-dua ini tidak cukup dominant. Okay, when the genotype is CR, the display phenotype will be dia akan dapat warna apa ni?
Red.
Okay. And then if the genotype is CW, so it will give
white.
But now in heterozygous condition, which is CRCW, what is the color?
Pink.
Sebab apa? No allele will be fully expressed in heterozygote condition. Tak ada satu allele pun yang akan tonjolkan sepenuhnya dalam keadaan heterozygote. So bila dia tak tertonjol sepenuhnya, dia akan jadi intermediate color. Dia akan mix, dia akan forming mixture. Okay, and then forming intermediate color or intermediate phenotype. So dalam kes ini, apa yang akan dapat adalah warna pink. Okay, akan dapat adalah warna pink. So ini apa maksud incomplete dominant? Kamu tulis definition dia. Tulis dalam, cari dalam buku kamu tadi. Maksudnya apa? The allele is not fully expressed in both allele is not fully expressed in heterozygous condition. So end up with mixture phenotype. Okay, intermediate phenotype. Dapatlah warna pink. Then kalau soalan kata construct genetic diagram of Safe Cross. Okay. Dia suruh kamu construct genetic diagram Safe Cross. Between siapa? Between the parent genotype. Bila kata Safe Cross, sah-sahnya adalah hetero. So CR, CW, cross with CR, CW.
Okay, so dia bagi genotype untuk self cross ni, CRW dengan CRW. So kita ada gamet setiap satu tu, satu tu CR, satu lagi tu CW tu, satu red, satu white. So bila kita silangkan dia, kita dapat F2 genotype dia, CR-CR, CRW, CRW dan CW-CW. So genotype ratio dia akan jadi 1-2-1. Untuk F2 genotype ni, kita dapat red, pink dan white. Untuk ratio, kita dapat 1 red, 2 pink and 1 white.
Okay. Alright. Okay, so maksudnya nanti kalau macam tu, kamu kena tulis CR, CR, bawah CR, CR tu red. CR, CW tu pink. Lagi satu CR, CW tu pun kamu kena tulis pink. CW, CW tu pun kamu kena tulis white. Faham tak? Ha, lepas tu kalau kamu tersalah dari situ. Lepas tu yang apa yang kamu tulis dekat F2 phenotype tu, itu patutnya dipindahkan ke bawah. Itu adalah cara penulisan untuk phenotyping. Ratio. Okay. So apa yang Aiman buat ni, itu je yang salah, yang lain tu betul. Okay, so tepat sekali. So my question is, do this case, okay, do this case follow Mendelian's law?
Tak.
Tak.
Tak. Why? Reason kalau dia minta dua?
Sebab tak ada dominant kot.
Yes, because both allele is in complete dominance ataupun there is no dominant allele and recessive allele in this case. Satu markah. Lagi satu markah, kita boleh tackle daripada mana?
Ratio ke ni?
Yes, good. Ratio. The phenotypic ratio of the self cross is not 3-1. Dia dapat? So the next case, number 4, we call this as polygene. Polygene, polynucleotide. Ha. Poly maksudnya apa?
Banyak.
Banyak.
Banyak. Mendel kata, okay, Mendel said, daripada Mendel eh. Dia kata, one gene, one characteristic. Betul? Okay. So, contohnya, kalau kata color ni, contohnya kalau color, gene color, gene yang ada P besar, P kecil, so dia hanya refer pada color saja. So maksudnya color ni hanya satu gen je yang terlibat, iaitu melibatkan sepasang allele sahaja. Boleh faham? What Mendel said, one gene is shown ataupun dia, satu gene tu dia refer kepada satu ciri sahaja. Dan kita dah tahu one gene is controlled by pair of allele. So the color, color, okay, cirinya adalah color. So color ni merujuk kepada satu gen di mana dia dikawal oleh allele P besar dan P kecil. But some case, apa yang jadi, one characteristic, for this, kamu kena ingat definition dia eh, sebab saya takut kamu tiba-tiba soalan dia minta kamu define banyak. Sebab kita tak tahu bentuk soalan kamu tu macam mana lagi. So this one pun sama, cari definition yang lengkap dari kamu punya bullet. So one characteristic is actually controlled by more than one gene. Boleh dapat tak? Patutnya Mendel kata satu gene, satu characteristic. Tapi sekarang ni, one characteristic controlled by more than one gene. For example, is human skin color. Contohnya human skin color. For example, gene satu Dia ada sepasang allele. Dia ada allele A besar, allele A kecil. A besar, this is for duck. This is for fair. Okay, this is dominant allele and A kecil is recessive allele. Gene 2 also control the skin color. But the allele is B besar. This is for dark, dominant also. And the B kecil, this is for fair, recessive. And the third gene, sampai tiga gene dia ada. Okay, C besar, this one is for dark, which is dominant. And then C kecil, this one is for fair, recessive. Okay, so nampak tak? One characteristic, cirinya apa? Skin color. Tapi ada berapa gene yang kawal skin color tu?
Tiga.
So, bila genotype, contohnya A besar, A besar, B besar, B besar, C besar, C besar. If this is the genotype. So, apa jadi dengan phenotype dia? Dia lah the darkest person in the world. Sebab dia dengan semua allele-allele dominant. Boleh faham? Okay, tapi kalau genotipnya adalah A besar, A kecil, B besar, B kecil, C besar, C kecil. So dia jadi apa? Skin tone dia?
Dark juga.
Dia dah jadi, nampak tak? Dia jadi apa? Gelap juga ke?
Gelap sikit.
Dia akan jadi, memang semuanya kita nampak semuanya dominan kat sini kan. Okay, tapi at the end, dia akan hasilkan bukannya color seperti gelap macam ni. Okay, bayangkan pula kalau macam ni. Ini. Apa pula color dia? Okay. Kalau macam ni. Apa pula color dia? Nampak tak? Terlalu banyak combination genotype. Terlalu banyak genotype. So akan menghasilkan skin tone yang pelbagai. That's why lah skin tone kita takkan sama. Sebab the skin tone is controlled by more than one gene. So more than pair of allele involved. So the genotype will be various. Terlalu banyak genotype. So at the end, the phenotype also akan ada terlalu banyak. Akan ada banyak varian phenotype. Ada dengan kulit sawo matang, ada dengan kulit kuning langsat, ada dengan kulit putih kemerah-merahan, ada dengan kulit